So today I'm here with my friend Miyaso, and I want to talk a little bit about astrology and what astrology can do for you.
So if you were talking to a young person who's never really been exposed to astrology, what would you want them to know, or why would you suggest that anyone even learn or have a reading?
Mm-hmm. Well, astrology is, especially for the person who receives it, is really kind of a wisdom perspective onto themselves. So it's kind of an invitation I'm extending out to you to step back with me and to have a neutral look at who you are in your potential, in your personality, in your psychodynamics. And then as an evolutionary astrologer, I always add the perspective of your soul's journey and your soul's destiny, what you really need to learn and what trauma you might have to heal this lifetime. So everything in astrology, it doesn't matter which kind of technique or way of looking at it you use, it all comes back to your individual horoscope, your personal chart. So it doesn't matter if we do forecast readings or synastry readings with your partner or parenting readings, it all is based on your natal chart. So your natal chart is your map for success in life. It's your blueprint. It's who you are, how you approach life. And you always live your chart. It's only the matter if you live it on the high road or somewhere in between, mm-hmm. towards the highest possibilities. You know? And on the low road, we can say we more learn through resistance and suffering and pain. And so higher up we get, so easier the journey is. It's like here in Hawaii, we know it's easier to surf the wave and to go with the energy than trying to fight against mm-hmm. it.
So would you say then that your job is to teach people how to take the high road, so to speak?
Exactly. My intention is to give you choices, to give you a higher perspective which leads you to better choices and therefore for more success in all different areas in your life.
That's beautiful.